So for the 15th Sunday in Ordinary Time, we have this text, which is taken from Psalm 54. I've mentioned in previous weeks that we've been following the Psalter, at least in the order of the Psalms, from which the introits are taken. We'll find that this week and next week, this nice arrangement has been altered. Sad to say, it was part of the liturgical revision that took place after Vatican II. Next week's introit comes from Psalm 53. And in the calendar, the old calendar, or the calendar that you'd be using if you're celebrating the extraordinary form today, these two introits would be reversed so that the one from Psalm 54 comes after the one from Psalm 53. Be that as it may, they're both wonderful introits whenever you sing them. What interests me about this particular introit as an exemplar of what's normally given to us as the text to prepare us most proximately to participate in the sacrifice of Mass is that so many of the introits during Ordinary Time speak to the Lord or speak about the Lord in such a way as to invoke this spiritual battle that we're in. I've mentioned this a couple of times. So we begin by saying, when I cried out to the Lord, he heard my voice and rescued me from those who were attacking me, who were coming near to me. So what we need to do when we come into church is to recall that as long as we are in this place of pilgrimage, we're not at our heavenly home. We are engaged in the spiritual battle. When we enter into the church, we have to leave that world behind and start to focus our minds on our final home, our heavenly home. And so we go through this same motion that Christ did. We have to go through the cross. We have to go through this, our death to ourselves. And when we cry out to the Lord because death, because evil is coming near us, he hears our voice and rescues us. We're going to sing the last phrase now for you. Iacta cogitatum tui, Dómino. Distracted, we have all of the previous week's worries still lingering, we have the coming week's worries in front of us, and the psalmist says, cast your thoughts on the Lord, you know, whatever is bothering you, give it to him. And what does he do? He feeds us, he nourishes us with Holy Communion. It's really a very beautiful text to prepare us for Mass. But a reminder again, it's a very different ethos than, say, what's more typical in the Mass today, where we'll have more of a celebratory hymn at the beginning, which maybe has the effect of sociologically bringing the community together in a certain way. That happens in this chant, but the content, going back to the Psalter very clearly, using this idea of the spiritual battle as we make our way as the church militant toward our homeland, this is a much more traditional understanding. I think it's theologically quite rich. Maybe it takes a little bit of effort to enter into if you're not used to it, as we are in the monastery. But I think it would be very good if more of our parishes were able to recapture this particular theological ethos. So one more time from the beginning. When I cried out to the Lord, he heard my voice.